entrance antiphon. Your merciful love, O God, we have received in the midst of your temple. Your praise, O God, like your name, reaches the ends of the earth. Your right hand is filled with saving justice.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have great business in my thoughts and in my words,
that what I have done, I know how to fail to do.
Through my fault, through my fault,
and through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
Now, mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Judah approached Joseph and said, I beg you, my lord, let your servant speak earnestly to my lord, and do not become angry with your servant, for you are equal to Pharaoh. My lord asked your servants, have you a father or another brother? So we said to my lord, we have an aged father and a younger brother, the child of his old age. This one's full brother is dead. And since he is the only one by that mother who is left, his father dotes on him. Then you told your servants, bring him down to me that my eyes may look on him. Unless your youngest brother comes back with you, you shall not come into my presence again. When we returned to your servant, our father, we reported to him the words of my lord. Later, our father told us to come back and buy some food for the family. So we reminded him, we cannot go down there. Only if our youngest brother is with us can we go. For we may not see the man if our youngest brother is not with us. Then your servant, our father, said to us, as you know, my wife bore me two sons. One of them, however, disappeared, and I had to conclude that he must have been torn to pieces by wild beasts. I have not seen him since. If you now take this one away from me too, and some disaster befalls him, you will send my white head down to the netherworld in grief. Joseph could no longer control himself in the presence of all his attendants. So he cried out, have everyone withdraw from me. Thus no one else was about when he made himself known to his brothers. But his sobs were so loud that the Egyptians heard him. And so the news reached Pharaoh's palace. I am Joseph. he said to his brothers, "Is my father still in good health?" But his brothers could give him no answer. So dumbfounded were they at him. "Come closer to me," he told his brothers. When they had done so, he said, "I am your brother Joseph, whom you once sold into Egypt. But now do not be distressed, and do not reproach yourselves for having sold me here. It was really for the sake of saving lives that God sent me here ahead of you." The word of the Lord. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. When the Lord called down a famine on the land and ruined the crop that sustained them, he sent a man before them, Joseph, sold as a slave. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. They had weighed him down with fetters, and he was bound with chains, till his prediction came to pass, and the word of the Lord proved him true. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. The king sent and released him. The ruler of the peoples set him free. He made him lord of his house and ruler of all his possessions. Remember the marvels the Lord has done. Alleluia. 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 Repent and believe in the gospel.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, "As you go, make this proclamation. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, drive out demons. Without cost you have received, without cost you are to give. Do not take gold or silver or copper for your belts, no sack for the journey or a second tunic, or sandals or walking stick. The laborer deserves his keep. Whatever town or village you enter, look for a worthy person in it, and stay there until you leave. As you enter a house, wish it peace. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. If not, let your peace return to you. Whoever will not receive you or listen to your words, go outside that house or town and shake the dust from your feet. Amen, I say to you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah on the day of judgment than for that town." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The kingdom of heaven is at hand. It seems like such a simple declaration, and yet it's one of the most profound truths, perhaps the most important truth of our lives. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. What does that really mean? Jesus is here. Jesus is with us. He is the kingdom. The kingdom is in him. He is our gateway to the Father and the Holy Spirit and eternity in heaven. Jesus is with us, especially as he's present in the Eucharist. This ought to be life-changing, and yet so many different cares and concerns of our everyday lives might distract us, might take us away from this truth. And so today we ask him at this Holy Mass to help us to remain mindful that the kingdom of heaven is at hand, that we live and breathe in the midst of Jesus at every moment of our lives. We also recognize this command of his to make this proclamation. We who have recognized it for ourselves, we by his grace live according to this truth. We are to share this truth with others. It's not always going to be welcome. This would be inconvenient for many who would prefer to live godless lives, and we see plenty of that in our world. This proclamation might lead to some persecution, might lead, at the very least, to what you might call some social discomfort. But nonetheless, we listen to God, not the world. And so we follow this command to make the proclamation, the kingdom of heaven is at hand, to tell our brothers and sisters with joy and love in our hearts that Jesus is with us. We pray that they will receive this good news, but we trust him that even when they don't, we have peace, because we know in our hearts that Jesus is with us. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. We bring our prayers to the Father, who is the giver of all good gifts. For the Church, may the Holy Spirit guide all believers toward loving one another with perfect love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For public authorities, may God help them govern justly and promote peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer the violation of basic human rights, and for those working to bring them comfort and assistance, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our brothers and sisters who cannot be present in this sacred assembly, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God may they rest in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pause now for a moment to present our own needs to the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, please listen and respond to our prayers according to your will. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the grace of the Lord is in you, and the power of the Lord is all of
you. This oblation dedicated to your name, purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
With the people who follow us.
Let us give thanks to the Lord and our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures who serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 hol
accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you first of your Holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant your peace to guard and unite the government throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all those who hold to the truth and arm the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer for themselves and all who are here to them, for the redemption of their souls and for their health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In community with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Prosagas, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protection and help, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously accept this oblation of our service, that the whole family order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen, through Christ our Lord. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and preach the gospel in every nation, make it spiritual and acceptable, so it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them, as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father, our faith, the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne on the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who lose participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace, having been blessed through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, all who seek in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace through Christ our Lord. To us also, your servants, to those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, and bid us to beseech you into their company, not laying our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, who sanctify and fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant you peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of our world, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of our world,
and have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my
body, but only to the Lord is the word of my soul.
The communion antiphon. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed the man who seeks refuge in him. And for those joining us from home, an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant me pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks.